Everybody, welcome back. I haven't been vlogging in a while, so I thought maybe it's time today. And I'm actually done with all the stable work. So I'm gonna start riding, and I'm gonna start with Meatball before lunch, and then I'm gonna ride 4 other horses after lunch, and I'm gonna go away and have 2 lessons tonight. But first I'm gonna start riding Meatball. I also watered the floor a little bit because it's so dusty because it's been so crazy hot lately in Sweden. But yes, like I said, we're gonna start with Meatball. I'm gonna try to make this a little bit a stable vlog-ish, and I also think I'm gonna jump a few horses, maybe 2 horses, and maybe I can put some videos of that in this vlog. Who knows? I don't know. We'll see. But I'm gonna bring Meatball inside first of all. That's why I'm holding a carrot, because I'm gonna trick him to come inside, and then him and I are going to do some trotting in the woods. So we're gonna trot a lot today, and that's the plan. Have you ever seen anything dirtier than Meatball right now? I'm gonna start with clean him off a little bit, but he won't get bright white again because he's been rolling in dust. But actually, we don't brush the horses only to get them clean. We brush them because it gets the blood running in the body and it's super good for them. So usually I take this little rubber glove and I rub it all over my horses and then I brush them off. It doesn't matter if they are a little bit like the white horse got some stains, as long as they don't have mud or dirt where you put the equipment. And then I shower my horses every day before they go to sleep after paddock time, so they get clean anyway. But first I'll just take the rubber glove and massage them a little bit. As you can see, Meatball is almost tacked up. I'm just gonna put a bridle on him and there we go. And I also sprayed his entire body with his fly spray, what do you call it? Well, it's all in Swedish. Well, I use this to keep the flies and the mosquitoes and everything off their bodies. Meatball ain't super sensitive, but of course he gets a little bit annoyed. Eva is so sensitive, we actually have to put a fly sheet on him, even for riding. Oopsie. Yeah, but I'm not gonna bring the camera because it's too big to wear when I ride. But now Meatball and I are going. We're so ready. Right, Meatball? Can you see how light he's getting? He's almost white. He's turning more and more into a unicorn.
Yay, unicorn.
Look at the snack Meatball brought home. Mmm, snacks is always the answer. He can't eat with a bit, I don't know why. He's such a funny guy. But now I'm gonna put him outside his paddock. He's gonna have some lunch and I'm gonna have some lunch. Hey, food. This is so funny. Meatball, you're such a fatty. Oh, I love you, cutie. Now it's after lunch and I'm gonna take Ebba to the woods, and he is so sensitive to flies and mosquitoes, and it's so many now. So I bought this fly riding sheet the other day, so I'm gonna try it today. It's from Horseware, and hopefully we can actually managed to ride, because the other week when I went to the woods he was totally crazy. So hope this helps. Right, Ebbies? Let's go. So I'm done with Ebba and he got his mosquito outfit to go out in the paddock again. He's so sensitive, it's, oh my god, I never had a horse this sensitive to mosquitoes and flies. But he really needs cover every hour of the day, even indoors, because he gets so crazy. And as you can see, he's even fluffy on his legs. Can you see how much fur he got? Because I don't want to clip his legs, because when the flies land on his legs, he's so sensitive. Yes, you are a poor guy. Poor guy. But anyway, now I'm gonna jump first Mini, and then I'm gonna jump Donnie. So I'm gonna put the vlogging away for a little bit, jump down, and talk to you after that. So I'm done riding, and every time after you've finished riding, it's always a freaking mess. So I'm gonna clean everything up now, and then I'm actually gonna do some loose galloping with Meatball, because I work him twice a day now, because he's a little bit fat and out of shape, so we need to work on his body a little bit more. But first I'm gonna clean everything up, and then I'm gonna let the horses inside, because it's getting close to evening soon, so it's almost time to let them in. But first, we clean everything up. I actually have been doing some shopping. Shocker! So I can show you some new things that I bought. One of the things that I got was the fly rug for riding that I used on Ebba earlier today. But then I also got new boots for Ebba. I think they're really cute with a black sheepskin, but this is fake sheepskin, of course. Because since we have so great fake sheepskin nowadays, I don't think you should buy real sheepskin. Most of my stuff I use today is actually fake sheepskin, both on girths and boots and protectors. Then the old ones, of course, are real cheap. And then I got another pair of boots, also for Ebba. Because I have lots of boots, but all of them are too small for him. So those are from Kingsland, and it's also fake cheap. So this is not real cheap, but they are super soft. And the black ones are from... The brand is called... It says Arma here, and... Armor... I can't see. What does it say? Whatever. But they look really good. And they have one of those things on the inside that make the boots not spin. Then I got another pair of boots for Mr. Meatball. But I've been showing in this one, so they are dirty now. But it's this type of boots, you know. So those are for Meatball. And I also got a new sheet for Going and Glory. A net cover by Cavalleria Toscana. I'm gonna put the camera here so I can show this to you, because it's so beautiful. It's pink and white. Look at this. Can you even see the light pink? It says Cavalleria Toscana in the front. like this. So it's white and light pink, and got the light pink logo on the side. So this is perfect for put over the saddle or something when you're at the show, just to protect them from the flies. And it's so beautiful! Oh my god! Then I have one more thing that I'm gonna go and grab. Stay tuned. So, I have one more new thing that is pretty cool. Look at this. It's the shiny Sam Shield, Miss Shield, with a big sunscreen, and it's super shiny as you can see, and it's rosé gold with, I'm gonna see if it's focused, with diamonds really everywhere. And the diamonds goes from whitish to pink, and it gets darker and darker and darker. So back here it's dark pink, can you see? I'm gonna do like this so you can see the shimmer. And light, and oh, it's also small diamonds all the way on the rosé gold on the sides. Legit the coolest riding helmet ever. Oh my god, I love it so much. Then I actually also have some new things for myself, like breeches, and get a new shirt, two new shirts. Yeah, but I don't have it here, so I'll show you that in another vlog maybe. But this baby, oh my god, so beautiful. So, oh my god, the lighting, it's like I'm in under the sun almost. But time to do the tack cleaning, and I'm gonna start with the bridles and the breastplates and the girths. Then can I just show you what I use? This is almost empty, but I have more of those. A glycerin soap from Bruno Lagrange. Looks like this, or like this. And then I use this leather balm cream from Boutia. My French girl said Boutia. I say Boutia. But I'm Swedish, not French. Start cleaning. So I'm done riding. I'm pretty much done with everything at the barn, except giving the horse night food. The horses are inside, except for the Shetland ponies, which my mom is bringing inside at the moment. I'm gonna see them when I flip the camera around. They are over there at the red barn. So now I'm gonna drive the quad and fix the flooring at my outdoor arena. Say hi to the ponies! Shetty, spaghettis! So, well, now I'm gonna drive the quad with this special thing that's made for this material that we have on the outdoor arena. Then I'm going to have lessons for some kids. And then I'm pretty much done for today. I don't know if you can hear me because this, but whatever, let's do this. Boy, it's getting kind of late, but I'm pretty much done with everything now. It's 9:30 p.m. but I kind of sort of find out that I haven't showed you my new horse, my new family member, so we're gonna meet her now. She's legit the cutest little horsey there in the entire world. Here she is. OMG. Her name is Rootless. And she's by Diarado. Diarado Callahan. Her mother is one of my best horses, Tura, for change, that I've been jumping meter 40 classes on. And this little horse. She's 2 weeks old now. And she and I, we are already soulmates. We do everything together. We love each other. And we spend so much time together. Root. I call her Root. Root. From Rootless. Look at her. She just puts her head on me. My baby girl. Aww. Such a cutie pie. I love you. Hi. Look at that baby tooth. I think me and Root will be, we will be best friends. We're gonna be soulmates. And I totally think that she and I are gonna have a special bond because we already are so close. She trusts me so much. Are you ready to get up? Are you trying to get up? Aww. Well, with this cute view. No, I have one more thing I'm gonna show you before I finish this vlog. But for now, bye from me and Ruth. So, before I finish this vlog of today, I just have to show you one thing. I don't actually know if I talked about this in my... What is this? I don't know if I told you this already or not. I can't remember because I haven't vlogged in a while. Right now we're at my outdoor arena, my paddock. And it's kind of small. And yeah, it's kind of small, but now we're actually building an indoor arena. Ah, like, for real, I'm so happy. This is the best thing ever. I get the question all the time if this is my yard. And yes, it's my yard or my parents' yard or whatever you want to call it. It's our yard. It's our place. So, and now we're going to have an outdoor arena, an indoor arena, and a brand new stable. And it's so awesome. And we have lovely fields for the young horses and great paddocks for the older ones. I'm just so happy and I feel so blessed. And I'm gonna show you the progress. So, here was the big stallion paddock before. And there was a mountain that we had to put explosions to take away, take down. And then there have been lots of trucks. First with this layer of rocks that you put under these smaller ones. Then you put these smaller ones over it, and you drive that kind of thing to make everything even, and you use a laser to make sure it's all even. And we bought that kind of, I don't know, machine so we can dig everything in order. So here we're building a indoor arena, and we're also gonna build, I think we're gonna build 2 or 3 small paddocks. Just if you want to let the horse out before or after a show, an hour or so. So, I'm going to show you a little bit what the yard looks like. There we have Sniggle and Minnie's paddock and the ponies, the Shetland ponies paddocks. So the indoor arena is going to be here. Here we have the outdoor arena. And there is my mom and dad's house, my little truck. There we have the show horses paddocks. And behind that red house, it's a summer field, a big field. And down over there, it's 2 big fields, and we're going to build one more. And just, I don't know if you can see, over there we have the new stable. So it's pretty close. And over here, in the future, we're going to also build a walker. But that's a further project, because we have so much to do right now. But yeah, you can see how amazing is this. Yes. I'm sorry, I'm just I'm just so happy, and hopefully this indoor arena will be done before the winter time. That's the plan. So we're just waiting for the guys that can come here and put the building up, and then we're all set. So I'm so happy, and we're of course gonna put like the top flooring and everything. Like it's gonna be super, super grounding for the horses to work on and everything. So. I'm so happy. So much mosquitoes. I need to end this vlog because they are biting me and I can't get... Can you see? They bite me here on my double chin. Well, time to end this vlog and... Yeah. I hope you're happy for me too because I'm so happy. So I'm gonna end this vlog now and say thanks for watching and all that. You already know. I love you. Hejdå!